playing basketball. We love that basketball.
Basketball is my favorite sport. I like the way they dribble up and down the court. Just like I'm the king on the microphone. So if Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunks, it takes me to the beat. My favorite play is the alley-oop. I like the pick and roll, I like the give and go. Cause it's basketball, Mr. Curtis.
Alright folks, welcome to the channel Skins for Life. As you see here, I have NBA 2K12, and I'm kind of shocked that when I go on Xbox Live and I check out all my friends list that no one has played this game yet. But I expect this game to pick up some gameplay soon from the other commentators, but I figure I'd be one of the first ones to bring you some footage of what I've gotten so far. I absolutely love this game. That's why they made it the NBA. It's amazing, this game. Now you see the intro right here. And I thought by playing the demo that I was only going to get one song, but apparently I don't get just one song. I get like a bunch of songs that play in the intro. The intros themselves that introduce the starting lineups are dynamic. That's what they said that they were going to do, and they do it. Now, the intro I get is the one that I think a lot of people thought this is just going to be a playoff type intro, but here you go. I play with the Wizards. That's the team that I run with. That's the team that I'm used to. Yeah, they're after me. That was the police. Nah, it's probably ambulance. I live near a hospital, so that's the sirens you hear in the background. But anyway, those the intros, those are dynamic. I'm like, you have those intros, then you have like the standard, like still picture, everybody standing side by side. Sometimes they'll do it with both teams standing next to each other, and sometimes they'll do it individually. But definitely enjoying the mess out of this game. So I'm not going to talk too much through some of this footage. I'm actually going to wait until the next clip to actually chime in, because there's definitely gonna just show you some footage, and I'm not even gonna talk over it. I'm just gonna let you guys see for yourself.
Economic or salary cap ingredient to it. So I think you're right. It was probably more about the arena's contract. And I think that's a nice move. Again, it's one of the pieces you have to put in place to have a chance to build going forward.
Well, that's really a nice point about, you know, being in a front office like you are in the NBA. You do have a completely different perspective of what a trade can mean, not just players involved, but all the ramifications.
Exactly. You got to look at all the dimensions.
And the rebound goes to the Knicks.
I tell you what, folks, I bet he won't miss that shot next time he takes it.
Phillips against McGee. Launches it. No good. Now the Wizards with it.
I tell you what, Andre Blatch, guys, has always been a tantalizing blend of skill and athleticism. He's 6'11". He can score inside and out. He can put the ball on the floor. And a very impressive talent.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
I was able to talk with Flip Saunders for a minute. Their opponent today is one of the more intelligent offensive teams in the league, so coach wants his guys to be patient and disciplined defensively. We can't get impatient and start trying to open.
Wizards trail by 5. Outside, Wall. Kicks it to McGee. who is outside to stop the drought, and that one's good. Lewis has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Now the Knicks with it.
Flip Saunders leading the charge in the district. I mean, the Wizards have a lot of young talent, and Saunders has seen this before when he broke.
Outside, Wall. And Young backs in. And Zuryov pulls it down. Abdul-Rauf. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Abdul-Rauf will always be Chris Jackson to LSU fans, but after a year in the NBA, converted to Islam and changed his name. Yeah, he was a very outspoken young man, bright and very socially conscious.
And it's tied up with that one. And Abdul-Rauf, very controversial too, Clark. You may remember, for his refusal to stand for the national anthem. He saw it as a critique of some of the nation's injustices, but it did not go over well, to say the least. You know, Steve, there was no doubt about it. That incident probably hurt his career as much as any, and, of course, injuries later on.
Oh, for sure. I mean, the city of Denver really turned on him, you know, after that incident. And it was really unfortunate the way it played out. He was just trying to make a political statement, but obviously got himself in some hot water. But he was a phenomenal shooter and scorer, somebody who could really play.
His eyes were wide open there, guys. Excellent vision to see they had an open shot outside and get it there.
Here's Pat. This is it to Stiff. Hakeem Olajuwon grabs the rebound.
That's what they call the million-dollar move with the 10-cent finish.
Here's Bullard. Olajuwon back and down. Tries in the post, and he sinks the layup. And it's a 4-point Rocket lead.
No, they're just getting hammered inside and really need to find a way to be tougher down there. They got to be physical. They got a man up in there.
I agree. I mean, you look at the points they're giving up, most of them seem to be coming inside the paint.
Here's Abdul-Rauf. He's got 15. He passes to Pat. And again, Denver no good.
You got a narrow edge here in rebounding early on. You wonder how much that'll play going forward.
Well, I like the way they've set the tone. You know, they're going to have to continue to work at it, but rebounds will be key in this game, no question about it.
Here's Abdul-Rauf. Here's Rodgers on the mark from 16 feet out.
Rodgers was an absolute stud when he was in college at Wake Forest, fellas. I mean, he won ACC Player of the Year in 93 and had his jersey retired by the Demon Deacons.
Well, the Nuggets grabbed him with the number 9 pick in 93, Clark, and he's really the young guy on this team, but a very productive one.
And it's Olajuwon missing. Here's Pat. Here's Abdul-Rauf. Gathers, and the layup falls.
Okay, so I'm busting back in on this point because the last clip was of the Houston Rockets and the Hakeem Olajuwon. Many times I tried to do the dream shake. I'm telling you, I'm going to do the dream shake. That's all I want to do in this game, is do the dream shake. I did a little bit of it. If I do the dream shake, I'm going to just drop the controller and just scream. No, I'm not going to scream, but I'm going to just drop the controller because that shit is amazing. No game you're able to do the dream shake except an NBA 2K12 game. This is just nuts. Look at this. This is back in the 60s, man. Actually, earlier than that. And they have it with the grainy footage. I have Sony Vegas Movie Studio software, and I could make my videos look like this. To play like this with the actual grainy radio broadcast sound, the classic clock, the sidelines, a regular like fold-out table. Look at the details. Now you see, I'm working with Bill Russell. in the post game is like that this year. That's why I was using Akeem Olajuwon in the last clip, and I'm using Bill Russell in this one. But I'm gonna exit back out because I want to come back in, like I said, at the very end and talk about the play that will come up, the clip that will come up after watching Lakers vs. Celtics in the blue day.
He's quite up there as a legend in the game. Russell sends it back. Now that's vintage Bill Russell, just in complete control of the defense. Jones against West. Jones kicks to Russell. Clock at six. Havlicek knocks it down from 19 feet.
Well, we saw him start the game here, but Hondo made his name coming off the bench.
He pretty much was a pioneer, Steve, as far as using the sixth man. I mean, guys like Ginobili has followed in his footsteps.
Fallback baby Dick Barnett with the pretty J.
Sometimes folks forget about his decent mid-range jumper. He can knock those down all game given a chance.
Now here's Jones. Defended by West. Jones, no luck.
Now he was right there, but the defensive pressure forced that miss.
Well contested. That really made it a tough shot. That shot was possible because of Jerry West's super quick release.
Here's Jones. Jerry West making his last shot. Over West. And the basket by Jones. Here's West. Ellis with a screen on Jones. Got a piece of it.
You know, you talk about Russell's blocks, but don't forget how great of a thief he was, too, as evident.
Oh!
Now, that's a special order right there.
Not everybody can cap off a dunk like that.
Yeah, very difficult maneuver, but a tremendous one if you can pull it off.
For Peyton. Bulls trail by
all right,
five.
So this is the play I wanted to come in on. Now look at Jordan calling for the ball. He's like, give me the fucking ball.
Outside Jordan.
And then he proceeds to do this with it. Now first I got to clear everybody out. And then, here's Jordan. Watch Jordan. Yes! And the funny thing is, he proceeds to step over him afterwards. That animation to step over somebody after you dunked on him was not in last year's game. Now let's watch it again. Ooh, he just mushed him. It was like, get out of my way. That's what NBA 2K12 is bringing this year. More attitude, more vicious dunks, and just a step over. Actually, that looks more like a step through. A little bit of morphing. Actually, a lot of morphing. But pretty much the dunk was clear cut. Jordan-esque over deadlift shrimp, not dentlift, deadlift shrimp. But I can only imagine if I can get Pippen to do that same dunk over Ewing, I'm gonna get a different animation where he actually extends his arm out like he did in that playoff game. Knicks fans hate that, but I was jumping out of my seat when that happened. I was like 15 years old screaming because Pippen just dunked on Ewing. But anyway, that's how excited I am to have this game. It's a must-buy. It's a 9.3, 9.5 with the critics. I give it a 9.9. There's no such thing as a perfect game. This is close. Peace.
Back to Perkins. Launches it. Here's Kemp. The second chance bucket is good. And this game is tied up now.